all eyes will be on Philippine hoops prodigy Kai Soto tomorrow as he attempts to become the first homegrown Filipino to make it to the NBA. This 7'3" Soto is among the dozens of hopefuls who have made themselves available for the 2022 rookie draft. Soto is seen as a possible late second round pick. The former Ateneo star has recently worked out with the Sacramento Kings and the Indiana Pacers. The NBA draft will take place at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. From the Austrian capital of Vienna is again the world's most livable city in 2022. According to a report from the Economist Intelligence Unit, Vienna reclaimed the top spot from Auckland, which tumbled down to 34th place due to COVID restrictions. The report said good infrastructure and healthcare, plus wide opportunities for culture and entertainment, are some of the city's main charms. In second spot, Copenhagen, followed by Zurich, Calgary, and Vancouver. The index placed the war-torn Syrian capital, Damascus, as the least livable city. American singer-songwriter Billie Eilish coming to the Philippines for a concert for the first time ever. The 20-year-old multiple Grammy winner will perform at the Mall of Asia Arena on August 13. Eilish was supposed to come to the Philippines September 2020, but it was postponed due to the pandemic. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. graces the celebration of Bacoor's 10th cityhood anniversary. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo now joins us live with an update. Kat, over to you.
Hermina, President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. went back to Cavite this morning to personally thank Caviteños for giving him a million votes in the recently concluded 2022 national elections. He said that if not for Cavite's help, he would not have had a majority, an overwhelming majority of votes that catapulted him to the presidency in the recently concluded polls. In his speech during the 10th cityhood anniversary of Bacoor, Marcos also underscored that a lot of Caviteños are his allies. Among these are Senator Bong Revilla Jr., who is part of Lakas CMD, the political party of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte, and Cavite Representative Jesus Crispin Remulla, the brother of Cavite Governor John Vic Remulla, who is also set to become his justice secretary come July 1st. Hermina, aside from thanking Caviteños for their support in the national elections, Marcos also noted that he was instrumental in the cityhood of Bacoor as he was the chairperson of the Senate Committee on Local Government that approved the bill that proclaimed Bacoor as a city back in 2012. This is also why Bacoor Mayor Lani Mercado Revilla repeatedly thanked Marcos in her speech, noting that if not for Marcos's help, then Bacoor may not have been a city today. Mercado Revilla also underscores that she and her allies in Cavite will also support President-elect Marcos's decision to personally head the Department of Agriculture in the coming months. Mercado, or Revilla, also mentioned in her speech that she hopes that the construction of 3 LRT stations in Cavite, as well as other infrastructure projects here in her domain, would push through seamlessly under the Marcos administration. Hermina.
All right, Kat, you know, there have been reports coming out that there are new additions to President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s cabinet. Is there any sense that you get that they're going to announce new names soon? And do you have any inkling as to who those people are?
No formal announcement yet from the camp of President-elect Marcos, but we received word from several sources that assert that the DOTR, that the Secretary of the Department of Transportation, may be announced either today or tomorrow. We have received names, but our sources have yet to confirm this on record, so I'm not yet at liberty to say the names on air. Hermina.
And so we wait. Katrina Domingo there joining us live from Bacoor in Cavite. Thanks, Kat. Take care. Keep safe. Well, back here in the newsroom, preparations continue for next week's inauguration of President-elect Marcos. The Philippine National Police again inspected the National Museum, the venue for the event. PNP officer in charge Vicente Dano says more than 7,000 policemen will be securing the area on June 30. The Interior Department earlier said it has received reports of a plan by leftist groups to disrupt the event.
The implementation, lalong-lalo na po yung pagpunta rito sa area, will be very, very strict. Ano, pinagbabawal po natin yung pagdadala ng mga bags, no? And any other covered materials. We will only allow transparent material.
Sa ngayon, wala kami nakikitang banta o threat no sa inauguration ng President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. No? Except yung mga rallies na po pwedeng gawin ng mga kaliwang grupo, nakahanda na rin tayo dyan.
At least 500 Coast Guard personnel will also be deployed in parts of the Pasig River.
Major thoroughfare yan din yung Pasig River. So dyan, yung PSG, control dyan ng Presidential Security Group. And of course, the Coast Guard, we are deploying assets there. Nag-implement tayo ng closure dyan kapag merong malalaking event ang Pangulo natin.